أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح.
الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين فيا أيها الناس أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله فقد فاز المتقون أما بعد Brothers and sisters in Islam, we are all human beings. We are not angels. We are not robots. We have feelings. We have emotions. We have desires. We have interests. Not only self-interest, but selfish interest. And we have carnal desires. And at the same time, we belong to this planet Earth full of temptations. Temptation to carnal desires. We belong to this planet Earth and Satan is with us, tempting us 24/7. Lifetime. So with our nature, that it is in our nature that we are human beings, we have weaknesses and we have lust and we have greed and we have the inclination to commit sins and we belong to this dunya full of sins. What do you expect? Hundreds of trillions upon trillions of more trillions of sinners from the time of Adam up to the last day. Now how could we bring ourselves back unto the Almighty Allah since we are sinners? No one among us in this congregation could say that I am a sinless man. Whoever says in this congregation that I am a sinless man, you are a liar. We are all sinners. It is in our nature as human beings to commit sometimes mistakes. And we belong in this planet Earth full of temptations. Now, how could we bring ourselves back unto the Almighty Allah, since the committing of sin, every time that you are committing a sin, is a step away from the Almighty Allah. You are moving away and away, farther away from the Almighty Allah. And how could we go back? By the mercy of the Almighty Allah, He legitimized a means for us to go back. That is by way of repentance, by way of tawbah, by way of asking the forgiveness of the Almighty Allah, by way of our repenting to Him and asking the forgiveness of the Almighty Allah, we are moving ourselves back unto the right path of living a life of submission to the will of the Almighty Allah. And this is the beauty of Islam. As we mentioned, we are all sinners. The frequency is either every minute, or maybe once a day, or maybe once a week, whatsoever is the frequency. But still, the truth is there that we are all sinners, that we have to go back to the Almighty Allah for us to become successful. The ayah says, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim." وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And turn, all of you, in repentance to Allah, meaning go back to Allah. True repentance, true asking His forgiveness, through tawbah, go back to Allah. And turn all of you in repentance to Allah, O believers, in order that you may be successful. So this is, brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the way, the means that we can go back to the Almighty Allah, since we are committing sin every now and then. Our eyes are committing sin, or if not our eyes, our ears are committing sin, listening to music, haram music, romantic music. Or if not our ears are committing sin, our tongue, or our hands, or our pockets, or our stomach, or our legs. We are using all these organs to disobey the Almighty Allah, and therefore we have to go back. And He gives us the chance every day to go back, but we do not go back. We do not ask the forgiveness of the Almighty Allah. Maulid al-Nabi came November 26th 2017, Muslims are committing bid'ah. Christmas, 25 December 2017 came, and Muslims are celebrating Christmas worldwide. And January 1, 2018 came the New Year, and Muslims are celebrating New Year. And no one is serious enough to ask the forgiveness of the Almighty Allah to go back. And every day we eat haram, and we do haram things, and nobody has a plan to go back. We are giving the chance to go back by way of repentance. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he himself, a sinless man. Prophets are sinless. He repented 100 times every day of his life. As mentioned in the hadith, O people, turn to Allah in repentance and seek His forgiveness, for surely I make repentance 100 times every day. Sahih Muslim. If Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam repented 100 times every day, much more me, much more you, much more all of us, because our eyes are committing sin now with the internet, subhanallah. And with your ears, and with your hands, and with your stomach, and with your pockets, and with your legs, subhanallah, we have to do it much more than Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because we are. It is in our nature to commit mistakes in life sometimes. Then we commit sin. so that we can ask the forgiveness of Allah, so that the Almighty Allah can show us His mercy. Every day He is giving us His chance of mercy to forgive us, so that He can give us His mercy of forgiving us, because He loves you, brothers and sisters in Islam. When you are asking the forgiveness of the Almighty Allah, He loves you, He is pleased. The ayah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Verily, Allah loves those who constantly turn to Him in repentance. The Almighty Allah loves you when you are asking for forgiveness. I repeat, verily, Allah loves those who constantly turn to Him in repentance and those who keep themselves pure. Now the question is, how can I go back to the way of submission to the Almighty Allah through repentance? How will I repent? How shall we repent, brothers and sisters in Islam? Number one, very important consideration for us, since we are human beings and it is in our nature that we have desires, we have carnal desires, we have lust, we have greed, we have the tendency to be tempted easily by Shaitan. How could we go back to the Almighty Allah? Number one thing that we must consider is remembering your Lord. How can you go back to your Lord if you do not remember Him? What we remember always are our cell phones. We always remember our cell phone every day. Facebook, love, whatsoever. And we forget our Lord, Almighty Allah. We always remember our cars, our homes, our wives, our children, our money, our bank accounts, our jobs, our career. And we do not remember Him. How could we ask forgiveness? Remembering the Almighty Allah is the greatest of all. Inna salata tanha anil fakhsha'i wal munkar wa la dhikrullahi akbar. Verily, regular prayer prevents shameful speech and unjust deeds, but the remembrance of Allah is the greatest. Remembrance of Allah is the greatest. When you are remembering your Lord, you feel satisfied in your career. When you are remembering the Almighty Allah, you feel the contentment in your life. When you remember the Almighty Allah, you are restraining yourself to do evil. And therefore, by remembering the Almighty Allah, we are living a peaceful life. We have a harmony within ourselves, and we are having a serenity every day, as mentioned in the ayah. Ala bi dhikri Allahi tatma'innul qulub. Without doubt, it is in the remembrance of Allah that the hearts find rest, the hearts find peace, the hearts find harmony. It is in the remembrance of the Almighty Allah. But the worst thing that will happen to us, brothers and sisters in Islam, is if we forget our Lord. Not remembering Him for one day, not remembering Him for one week, not remembering Him for one month. There is no Allah in your life for one whole year. Allahu Akbar. Then when the mind, the consciousness is empty of remembering the Almighty Allah, Shaitan the accursed, a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, it is very easy for him to feel your consciousness with demonic thoughts, with evil deeds, tempting you to carnal desires until you meet your malak al-maut and you do not have the chance to ask the forgiveness of the Almighty Allah. Therefore, brothers and sisters in Islam, number one thing is, wherever you are, either in your car, in your office, with your family, in your job, remember your Lord. Always. Number two, very important thing for us to repent and go back to the Almighty Allah. Since we are sinners and we have no plan, we have so many plans, short-term plan, long-term plan, medium-term plan, on how to become a successful husband, how to become a successful wife, on how to become a successful businessman, but we have no plan about asking the forgiveness of Allah. Now, number two, immediate repentance. The moment that you realized that you have committed a sin, brothers and sisters in Islam, the very moment that you realized that you have committed a sin, immediately you ask your Lord, you call your Lord, you ask for forgiveness. Ya Allah, forgive me. Something like that. Do not postpone for the next Ramadan. Many Muslims have today, while they are young, they told themselves, I will only repent when I get old. I will only repent when Ramadan comes. Why do you have to wait? Now move. You do not know. Never will you know. Maybe tonight is your time. Schedule with Malak al-Maut. Now how will you say? It's next Ramadan. The ayah says about immediate repentance. إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَحَالَةٍ ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ فَأُولَئِكَ يَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. Verily, Allah will forgive those who do sins and ignorance, and soon, meaning immediately, and soon turn in repentance. It is they whom Allah will forgive, and Allah is ever all-knower, all-wise. While you are postponing the tawbah, brothers and sisters in Islam, you will forget the details of your sins. After 1 year, after 2 years, after 3 years, Satan will teach you, he will coach you, he will tell you, my friend, you know, you do not have to be worried about what you had done 2 years ago. You know, you're a human being. You have weaknesses. You have sexual needs. Your wife is in abroad. And what do you expect, my friend? You are not a robot. You are not an angel. You're a human being. So your Lord will understand you. No need to repent. And you believe in Satan. And you do not repent. And you have forgotten already your zina. And you have not cleared yourself. Then when Malak al-Maut comes, my friend, you will see in the record book, they are numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 million, so many. All what we have done in this dunya are numbered. Subhanallah. So we must clear ourselves before the day that we cannot clear ourselves in the day of judgment. We must move quick. Do not postpone. This is the number two very important thing for us to ask the forgiveness of the Almighty Allah. Do not postpone. Move immediately. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Be quick. Move fast. Be quick in the competition for forgiveness from your Lord and for a garden whose width is that of the whole of the heavens and the earth, prepared for the al-muttaqun, prepared for the righteous. When you postpone your repentance, you tell yourself, this Ramadan I will repent full time. Then tonight is your schedule with Malak al-Maut. The ayah is very clear. وَمَن تَدْرِي وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. No soul knows what it will earn tomorrow, nor does it know in what part of the earth it will die. You do not know what will you earn tomorrow. You do not know how are you going to die. You do not know when are you going to die. You do not know where are you going to die. And why say tomorrow? Why say next Ramadan I will repent? Why not today? The moment that you repent immediately is a determining factor that your iman is improving, my friend. Number three, very important thing for us. Number three important point for repentance. Even if you repent immediately, every time you commit a sin, you repent immediately. But you keep on repeating and repeating and continuously doing the sin. It's useless. You're only fooling yourself. Repentance means immediately you cut off what you are doing. No matter how you love the woman, in an illicit affairs. She is not your wife. She is just your chatmate. And you meet in Cubao, you meet in Quiapo, you meet in Makati. She is not your wife. You love her so much. No matter how much you love that woman or that man, when you are repenting, repentance means you cut the relationship or you marry her and repent. If you cannot do it, my friend, then you are fooling yourself. You are not repenting. Repentance is very important for us to understand that the determining factor of tawbah is how you stop what you are doing that is offending to your Lord. No matter how you repent to the Almighty Allah, if you cannot restrain yourself, if you cannot control yourself, if you cannot stop yourself from the doing of haram, your repentance is useless. وَلَمْ يُسَرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ جَزَاؤُهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. And for those who do not knowingly persist in the wrong they have done, to make a direct translation, for those who no longer do what they are doing of haram. That is the direct translation, because we are reading a classical translation. And for those who do not knowingly persist in the wrong they have done is a reward of forgiveness from the Lord. So therefore, brothers and sisters in Islam, if you are really sincere to ask the forgiveness of your Lord, no matter how you love the money from haram, no matter how you love the means from haram, no matter how you love the wealth from haram, cut it off. Surrender to your Lord. Submit to His will. Ask His forgiveness. And go back to His way. The way of submission. The way of Islam. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim. Wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikri al-hakim. Wa taqabbala minni wa minkum tilawatahu innahu huwa as-sami'ul 'alim. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. عباد الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Brothers and sisters in Islam. The Almighty Allah, when you are truly repenting and you are doing good deeds at the same time. Because tawbah in Islam, it is not just a matter of feeling. It is not just a matter of words. But it is a matter of action as well. So once you are repenting, you are restraining yourselves from evil, and you are pushing yourself to do good deeds. And once you are repenting and you are restraining yourself from evil and you are pushing yourself to goodness, the Almighty Allah forgives the sinner. وَمَنْ تَابَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَإِنَّهُ يَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَتَابًا. And whoever repents and does good has truly repented to the Almighty Allah. So do good deeds. While you are repenting to the Almighty Allah, do some voluntary fasting, do some voluntary prayers, read the Quran, or give some sadaqah, whatsoever. Good deeds that you can do while asking the forgiveness of the Almighty Allah, while you are returning to the way, back to the will of the Almighty Allah, do good deeds. Because if you have done sin, evil, and you repent, and you do good deeds, the Almighty Allah will change your evil works with good. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Except those who repent, believe, and do righteous deeds. Repent,
believe and do righteous deeds.
Except those who repent, believe and do righteous deeds, those are the ones whose evil deeds Allah will replace with good, and Allah is of forgiving, most merciful. So therefore, brothers and sisters in Islam, this is how the Almighty Allah legitimized a means for us to go back to the way after committing sins in our life. We go back before we are brought back to Him. Before we are being brought back to Him, we must go back by way of asking His forgiveness. May the Almighty Allah give us the willpower, the guidance, the protection, that we try our best every day to go back. Amin ya Rabbal Alameen. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu tasliman. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله والحمد لله رب العالمين أقم الصلاة أقم الصلاة